For your enjoyment, the Canadian Football League is proud to present the 75th Grey Cup, a championship season. 1987 was a transitional season for the Rough Riders, a disappointing seasonal record overshadowed several fine performances. 94 catches for second-year receiver Mark Lewis. Speedy Gerald Alphen over from Montreal hauled in 8 touchdown passes. And on August the 9th, place kicker Dean Dorsey entered the record books. Dorsey set a CFL record for most consecutive field goals. Against Calgary, Dorsey kicked his 21st to tie Don Sweet's previous best. Later, he was successful from 41 yards out, and then from 20 yards to set the new CFL mark at 23. The 1987 edition of the Toronto Argonauts was led by team most valuable player, Darryl Smith. Smith was exceptional all season. 79 catches, 10 for touchdowns. Shenley Award winner Gil Fennerty was the cream of first-year players. Fennerty rushed for 879 yards and 15 TDs. The true strength of the Argos was their defense. Harding, Sellers, Kulka and Bayless up front. Linebackers Doug Landry, Don Moen, and Willie Pless had standout seasons. Defensive back Darnell Clash was electrifying on special teams. Quarterback Gilbert Renfro emerged as a team leader on offense. The defending Grey Cup champion Hamilton Tiger Cats were troubled with injuries throughout 87. Earl Winfield proved to be one of the league's most exciting on both offense and special teams. Steve Stapler returned and finished with a league-high 13 touchdown receptions. Tom Porras graduated to starting quarterback. And Ticat consistency on defense remained in the form of veteran linebacker Ben Zambiasi. Al Bruno has much to build on in 88. Consistency at every position characterized the Blue Bombers in 87. Winnipeg was led by the league's top rusher in Willard Reeves with his third 1,000-yard season. Tom Clements sparkled at quarterback. The CFL's most outstanding player passed for over 4,600 yards and an impressive 35 touchdowns. James West and number 35 Tyrone Jones anchored the aggressive and often intimidating defensive core. Defensive back James Jefferson led the Bombers in interceptions with 8 and scored 4 TDs in a single game. Shenley Award winner as the league's top Canadian, Scott Flagel, was noticeably effective from his safety position. The Saskatchewan Roughriders were extremely competitive in 87. Rookie head coach John Gregory saw the development of future star quarterbacks Jeff Bentram, Tom Burgess, and Kent Austin. Dave Ridgway became the first place kicker in CFL history to crack the 60-yard barrier. After a slow start, the Calgary Stampeders rebounded to become one of the league's most respected teams. Standout wide receiver Larry Willis was one of the reasons, over 1,400 yards on 74 catches. Quarterback Rick Johnson continued to be a team leader on and off the field. Canadian running back Tim Petros emerged as a strong performer and complement to Gary Allen. Stampeder confidence in backup quarterback Rick Warman was well placed. Veterans Vince Goldsmith and Harold Hallman were standouts on defense. Edmonton responded well to Jackie Parker's unexpected retirement and Joe Farragelli's appointment as head coach. Gizmo Williams set a CFL record 4 TDs on punt returns. Sophomore Tom Richards was also a threat on special teams. Backup quarterback Damon Allen led the team in rushing, while starting quarterback Matt Dunnigan returned from a midseason injury healthy and hungry. Brian Kelly surpassed Tommy Scott to become the league's all-time TD pass receiver. On defense, rookie Stanley Blair proved he belonged. 4 interceptions on the season, 1 return for a TD. Stuart Hill led the Eskimos in sacks with 18. The BC Lions finished first in the CFL's Western Division. One reason? They had the league's top defense. Mel Bird had three interceptions in one game. Number 18, Keith Gooch, had a season total of 9 pickoffs. 12-year veteran Lou Pasaglia just gets better with age. He scored a CFL record of 214 points. This punt gave BC an important victory. Quarterback Roy DeWalt completed over 300 passes for new head coach Larry Donovan. Jim Sandusky, a constant threat as a receiver and on special teams. The Eastern semifinal had the defending Grey Cup champs up against the Toronto Argonauts. Head coach Al Bruno returned to the bench. The Argonauts opened up the scoring. Edmonton native Lance Chomick connects from 16 yards out. Hank Olisek makes it 4-0 Toronto when he sails this 64-yard punt through the end zone. Quarterback Gilbert Renfro starts for the Argos. He finds veteran Paul Pearson for a 15-yard gain. That sets up another Lance Chomick field goal. The Argos up by 7. Tom Porras, making his first playoff start, has this pass picked off by defensive back David Daniels. The Argos move the ball down to Hamilton's 34, where Chomick connects to make it 10-0. Now in the second quarter with the score 11-0. Hank Olisek has his punt blocked by Terry Lenny. Lenny recovers the ball for a touchdown, and the Tiger Cats finally get on the scoreboard. Bernie Ruoff's second quarter punt is blocked by number 77, Rodney Harding. That sets up a 1-yard run by rookie Gil Fennerty. The convert puts the Argos in front by 11. Before the half ends, Bernie Ruoff closes the gap with this 52-yarder. 18-10 Toronto after 30 minutes. Second half action. A bobbled pass is intercepted by linebacker Don Moen. Lance Chomick adds another 3. The Tiger Cats try to mount a comeback. Porras to Stapler, a gain of 38 yards. The drive stalls. Ruoff makes it Argos 22, Tiger Cats 13. Last year's Grey Cup victory is only a distant memory now. Hobie has his sights set on Winnipeg. Gil Fennerty, a big gain, this one for 56 yards in the fourth quarter. Lance Chomick, the story, with 6 field goals. The Argos advance 29-13, the final. November 15th, the Calgary Stampeders visit Commonwealth Stadium. Head coach Larry Koharik guides a vastly improved club. Ferragelli starts Matt Dunnigan at quarterback. First quarter action. Milton Jones runs for 22. Next play from scrimmage. Dunnigan finds Brian Kelly wide open in the end zone. Edmonton leads 7-0. Stuart Hill sacks Rick Warman. In the second quarter, Dunnigan to Kelly. He breaks a tackle. The gain is 40 yards. Calgary's defense is playing well. Here, Dunnigan is picked off by Ron Hopkins. A few plays later, Kaurik is good from 48 yards out. 10-0 Edmonton. Calgary comes back. Big run from number 23, Gary Allen. That sets up J.T. Hay for a 17-yard attempt. It's good. The Stampeders right back in it. Stu Laird brings down the quarterback. Rick Warman drills one in for Larry Willis. The gain is 21. J.T. Hay makes good on his second attempt. The half ends. Edmonton 10, Calgary 6. Cowrick kicks for 3, and then Dunnigan, under pressure, is intercepted by Calgary's Greg Peterson. Peterson returns the ball 106 yards for the major. Midway through the third, the game is tied at 13. Edmonton regains the lead on this 46-yarder by Kaurik. Edmonton's defense comes up big. Here, number 95, Dan Kearns, picks off Warman. A Kaurik field goal is followed by this 12-yarder by Hay. Edmonton 19, Calgary 16. Midway through the fourth, Rick Warman is injured. That's all for 87. Rookie Carl Fodor gets a rude welcome from John Mandarich. Blake Marshall adds a late touchdown, and the Edmonton Eskimos are going to BC to face the Lions. The final, Edmonton 30, Calgary 16. The Eastern Final. Toronto journeys to Winnipeg to test the Blue Bombers. Veteran coach Bob Obilovich against first-year man Mike Riley. The defenses control the game. Both teams. Several fine defensive plays in the first quarter. After 15 minutes, it's scoreless. Starting quarterback Gilbert Renfro turns the ball over to the league's top ball hawk, Roy Bennett. Bennett's interception sets up a Trevor Kennard field goal. The Bombers up by three. The Argos on the offensive. Renfro looks deep for number one, Darryl Smith. He's got it. The gain is 48. Toronto first and goal from the one. Renfro keeps. Chomik converts. And Toronto leads 7-3. Hank Ilisek adds a single to make it 8-3. In the second half, a Winnipeg turnover sets up this Lance Chomik field goal from 27 yards out. Toronto up by nine. Fourth quarter action. Tony Johns goes over from the one. The Argos win 19-3 and go to the Grey Cup for the first time since 1983. The second place Edmonton Eskimos against the first place BC Lions, the Western Final. First quarter action. Dunnigan looks deep. Who else? Brian Kelly is there, and the Eskimos are up by seven. Still in the first, Jerry Kaurik punts to Larry Crawford. The veteran Lion, a great return, runs the ball all the way back to Edmonton's 12-yard line. The Eskimo defense holds the Lions. Lou Pasaglia comes in, and his three-pointer makes it 7-3 Edmonton. Still in the first quarter, Dunnigan again looks deep. Wide receiver Stephan Jones under tight coverage makes the catch. First and goal from the one. Running back Milton Jones waltzes in for the major. An excellent defensive play by Kevin Konar. And that sets up another field goal by Lou Pasaglia. Late in the half, Dunnigan goes the distance to Stephan Jones. 80 yards in the air for the touchdown. Edmonton leads 21-6. Third quarter. Kaurik adds three more to increase Edmonton's lead to 18. Milton Jones gets his second touchdown of the game to close out the scoring. Edmonton wins it 31-7, and now it's on to the Grey Cup. November 29, 1987, Toronto versus Edmonton in the 75th Grey Cup. The attention of an entire nation is focused on Vancouver's BC Place Stadium. And the week of festivities was unprecedented. Schenley honors Tom Clements as the CFL's most outstanding player. Laura May Laird captures the Miss Grey Cup title. Bobby Curtola entertained at the Grey Cup extravaganza. The Grey Cup parade, always a Grey Cup highlight. Edmonton's Matt Dunnigan starts his second Grey Cup game at quarterback. For Toronto, it's 24-year-old Gilbert Renfro, the Argos' most consistent performer at the helm. Former Edmonton Eskimo James Bell was in attendance. Injured in a game last season, Bell has been a constant inspiration for his teammates. Commissioner Douglas H. Mitchell assists the Honorable Otto Jelinek, Minister of State for Fitness and Amateur Sport, in the ceremonial kickoff. Canada's own, the Nylons, lead a capacity crowd of over 59,000 in the national anthem.
Oh, Canada, we stand upon the
Canada. Jerry Kowrick kicks off for the Eskimos. Dwight Edwards takes the kick at the Argo 17. A reverse to Darryl Smith fails to catch the Eskimos off guard. Mark Norman makes the tackle. Joe Farragelli in search of his first Grey Cup victory as head coach. He had won three rings while an assistant with Edmonton. And Bob Obilovich, the head man when the Argos won their last cup in 1983. On first and 10, running back Gil Fennerty finds a hole and gains 9.5. After getting the first down, Gilbert Renfro calls Fennerty's number again. The Holy Cross product and Schenley Award winner as CFL's Rookie of the Year romps 34 yards to the Eskimos 38. But the Argo drive stalls. Tight coverage in Edmonton's secondary by the West's top rookie, Stanley Blair, sends Renfro to the bench and brings Lance Chomick onto the field. Chomick's 46-yarder is wide to the right. Number two, the ever-popular Henry Gizmo Williams, returns it to the 22-yard line. The league's top offense takes over. In 1987, the Eskimos set a CFL all-time record for points scored in a season, 617. The Argos would have none of it. Number 99, Gerald Bayless, blasts into the backfield to bring down Matt Dunnigan. It didn't end there. Edmonton is forced to punt. On the next series, a charged-up Argo defense gets to Dunnigan again. This time, it's team sack leader Rodney Harding. Toronto gets the ball back. Still scoreless, Renfro rolls out and finds UBC's Paul Pearson for 11 yards. Next play, Fennerty up the middle, picks up 4. Then it's back to Pearson, this time for 10 yards and a first down. Edmonton's defense for the second time hold the double blue. Lance Chomick will try to get his team on the scoreboard.
This attempt from the right hash marks. And he again missed it to the right. Gizmo has a block and the sidelines. He has not stepped out. He may go all the way. He needs one block and he'll do it easily. He may not need the block. Henry Gizmo Williams scores.
Foot 7-inch Gizmo Williams electrifies the crowd. During the regular season, the Giz set a CFL record with 4 touchdowns on punt returns.
Now it's a Grey Cup record that he sets, returning the missed field goal 115 yards for the touchdown. Midway through the first quarter, and Edmonton leads by 7. Toronto comes right back. Renfro hits his favorite target. Darryl Smith hauls one in for a gain of 19. In his sophomore season, Smith led the Argos with 79 receptions and 10 touchdowns. On first down, Renfro looks to the sidelines rookie Gene Thomas. The gain is 9. But the Argo drive stalls again. Chomick, not looking for a repeat of his last attempt, connects on this 34-yarder. The Eastern faithful finally have something to cheer about. Toronto pulls within 4. A procedure call forces Edmonton into a 1st-and-15 situation. Dunnigan, over the middle, finds Simon Fraser's Rick House for a gain of 13. On second down, Dunnigan looks for a receiver, but number 32, Willie Pless, had other ideas. Pless thought he had the Argos' second sack. So did Coach Obilovich. But a Toronto holding penalty gives Edmonton a first down on their own 39. The CFL's all-time receiver, Brian Kelly, makes his first catch. Darnell Clash brings Kelly down on Toronto's 52. On the last play of the first quarter, Dunnigan scampers for 2 yards. After 15 minutes of play, Edmonton 7, Toronto 3. To start the second quarter, the Eskimos return to the inside passing game. Dunnigan guns the ball to House. Scrimmaging from Toronto's 34, Doug Landry, the heart of the Argos defense, bursts through. The loss is 6 yards. Second and 16. Dunnigan drops the ball off to number 34, Milson Jones. Jones is brought down just short of a first down. In comes rookie place kicker Jerry Cowrick. The Windsor native's first attempt is good. The Eskimos' lead is back to 7 at 2:04 of the second. 34-year-old Dwight Edwards fields the ensuing kickoff. The 10-year CFL veteran gives Toronto good field position at the 48. Fennerty picks up a yard on first down, and then Toronto shifts into high gear.
Cuts the blitz from the Eskimos. Renfro still has time. Throws it deep, intended for Fennerty. He catches it, and he scores.
For Gil Fennerty, another sensational play in what's been a sensational first season. For Toronto, a much-needed 6 points. Gilbert Renfro to Gil Fennerty, 61 yards for the touchdown. The Argos caught Edmonton in a man-to-man defense, isolating a running back with a linebacker. Chomick's convert is good. The 75th Grey Cup is tied 10-10 with 13:02 left in the second. Coach Bob Obilovich, his team back in the right direction. On Edmonton's next series, Matt Dunnigan swings a pass out for Bishop's grad Chris Skinner. Don Moan limits the gain to 5 yards. Second down, it's Skinner again. This time the gain is 10 and a first down. Dunnigan, unable to find a receiver, keeps the ball himself and picks up 14. The Eskimos move into Argo territory. Edmonton is threatening to take the lead. Defensive back Darnell Clash has another idea as he steps in front of the pass intended for Rick House. The Argos go back on offense. Darnell Clash, new haircut and all, records his second Grey Cup interception, the other one coming in 85. Toronto starts the drive at their own 32. Third-year Canadian Warren Hudson runs for 8. Renfro, back to pass. This time it's number 88, Jeff Smith, for 8. Fennerty picks up the first down.
the Argo spotters have seen something for Sam Sanders and Gerald Bayless to discuss. After a Fenerty first down, Paul Pearson gets 14 to the Edmonton 39. Then it's back to number six. Fenerty breaks to the outside, finally brought down on Edmonton's 28. Canadian Airlines lineman star of the year, Stuart Hill, makes his presence felt. Second and 12. Renfro hits number nine, Gene Thomas. Thomas picks up 20 yards, first and goal from the 10. Next play from scrimmage. Fenerty runs for six. Second and goal from the four. Argo's chance to take the lead.
From the four-yard line, Fenerty scores.
Gil Fenerty, in his first Grey Cup game, records his second touchdown. For the first time in the game, Toronto's in front 17-10 with 4:16 remaining in the first half. Coach Farragelli is concerned with Toronto's 14 unanswered points. Edmonton takes over from their 35. Rickhouse makes his third reception. The gain is 15.
Let's go, guys. Keep working. Let's get down there.
First and 10. Dunnigan drops back, looks to his right, and finds Chris Skinner. The swing pass works to perfection. Skinner gains 13 to the Argo 47. But Toronto's defense is relentless. Dunnigan is forced out of the pocket.
Dunnigan still has it thrown, and he now fumbles it. And this could be a Toronto touchdown. Doug Landry will go all the way.
Middle linebacker Doug Landry, the inspirational leader of the Argos, puts Toronto up by 14. Landry, playing with a severely bruised shoulder, is escorted 54 yards for the touchdown. Three consecutive TDs have Toronto ahead 24-10 with 2:20 remaining in the half. Edmonton native Glenn Kulka hammered the Eskimos quarterback. Dunnigan is on the sidelines getting medical attention. Damon Allen warms up quickly. Toronto isn't done yet. On the next series, Allen is welcomed by Dan Sellers, an 11-yard loss. The momentum had changed. The Argos were on a roll, and Edmonton needs a big play to stop them.
Yo, I love you. They look nice.
With less than 2 minutes remaining, the Eskimos get a break. Punter Hank Olesek bobbles the snap. Stanley Blair blocks the attempted punt. The Shenley rookie finalist gets through from the left untouched. Momentum shifts again. Damon Allen starts the green and gold off from Toronto's 40. Allen finds Milton Jones on the right side. The gain is 17. First down on the 23. Allen hands off to Jones, the draw to the 6-yard line. The directions from Farragelli are clear. First and goal, less than a minute left in the half.
Allen, touchdown pass to Marco Sintar.
Allen to University of Alberta grad Marco Sintar. Edmonton's depth at quarterback shows once again. Kaurik's convert is good. Toronto 24, Edmonton 17. The half ends with Fenerty running his rushing total to 89 yards. A dazed Matt Dunnigan heads for the locker room. At the half, Toronto 24, Edmonton 17. While the teams contemplate the 41-point first half with over 400 yards of net offense, fans were treated to a halftime show celebrating the CFL's 75th Grey Cup anniversary. The beauty of Miss Grey Cup contestants. Former CFL stars like George Reed, along with Jackie Parker, and a special Grey Cup song titled Heroes, proudly marked this milestone in the CFL's proud history. The teams are back for the start of the second half. Toronto's Hank Alissa kicks off. Williams returns the ball 23 yards to the Edmonton 45. With Dunnigan on the bench, Allen will lead the Eskimos at quarterback. On first and 10, the screen pass to Chris Johnstone gains 20. From Toronto's 45, an incomplete pass leads to second down. This time, Allen drills the ball into the sure hands of Brian Kelly. Edmonton continues to run quick hit patterns. Stephan Jones moves the ball to the Argos 13. David Daniels on the blitz meets Johnstone head on. The loss is three. It's third and three. Jerry Kaurick comes in for his second attempt of the day from 22 yards out. Kaurick goes 2 for 2. Toronto 24, Edmonton 20. With Edmonton within four, the fans at BC Place are being entertained by exceptional execution. Renfro failed to move the Argos. Edmonton has it first and 10 from their 37. Quarterback Damon Allen has trouble controlling the ball. Allen recovers his own fumble but has nowhere to go. Dan Sellers and Glenn Kolka combine to bring Allen down for a loss of 15. Dan Ferroni rests while Marco Sincar has a cramp attended to. Edmonton has to punt. Kaurick to Darnell Clash. Clash, the East top special team player, dances his way to a 17-yard gain. First down on Edmonton's 52. Gilbert Renfro keeps the ball. Renfro runs for 13. The tackle by Junior Robinson has Renfro slow to get up. Backup quarterback Danny Barrett will be in for at least one play. Trainers tend to Renfro's knee. In his fourth CFL season, Barrett was selected as backup over rookie John Congemi. Barrett's first call from scrimmage to Fennerty, off tackle, no gain. Renfro finishes the game 9 for 19, 153 yards passing. Now both starting quarterbacks are on the sidelines. Second and 10. Barrett rolls to his left. The Eskimos react. Stuart Hill finally brings down the Argo pivot. Stuart Hill registers his second sack of the championship game. The Argos must settle for a field goal try. Lance Chomick's attempt will be from the Eskimos 50. The third longest field goal in Grey Cup history is good. Toronto extends its margin to 7 at 7:56 of the third. After Elissick's kickoff, Edmonton scrimmages from its 28. Allen back to pass. He finds Rick House. House breaks a tackle and sprints 39 yards down to Toronto's 43. The Eskimo drive stalls. Kaurick comes in to attempt his third field goal from 42 yards out. The ball hooks wide to the left. Number four can't believe he didn't get three. Clash works the clock, then gives up the single point. Argo's lead is reduced to 6. Both teams earn victories against each other in 87. The third meeting is by no means decided. Junior Robinson on the safety blitz introduces himself to Danny Barrett with a jarring hit. The Eskimos have the ball at their 30. Allen stays with the short game. A sideline pass to Stephan Jones for 9. Now on the 41, after a Milton Jones first, Allen looks to pass. Pressure from the Argo front four collapses the pocket. Team sack leader Rodney Harding corrals Allen for the loss. Second and 13. Allen rolls out and hits Rick House for 21 and into Argo territory. From the Argonaut 51, Milton Jones finds an opening off tackle. The gain is 17. On the last play of the third, Allen completes a pass to Rick House. Edmonton is knocking at the door again as the third quarter ends. Fourth quarter, first down on the 15.
He caught it, and it is a touchdown.
Brian Kelly scores his fifth TD in Grey Cup competition. The touchdown brings Kelly alongside the great Hal Patterson for the all-time lead. Kelly hangs on to the ball despite the hit from Darnell Clatch. Cowrick's convert puts the Eskimos in front, a slim one-point lead. The fans were witnessing a classic. Responding to the challenge, Toronto charges back. Barrett looks for the Argos' number one receiver. Slot back Darryl Smith makes the catch for a 23-yard gain. Three plays later, fullback Warren Hudson gives Toronto a first at the Edmonton 29. But a tough Eskimo defense stops the Argonaut drive. Chomik, a chance to put Toronto back in the lead from the 32. His attempt is dead center. The Argos are back in front, 30-28 with 11:30 remaining. Edmonton takes over from their 35. Allen forced to run. Gerald Bayless strips the ball from number 9. Willie Pless recovers. Barrett from the Edmonton 45. The pressure again from the Eskimos' left side. Stuart Hill, number 36, for the third time, gets to an Argo quarterback. A failed second down attempt, and Toronto is forced to punt. Damon Allen puts the Edmonton offense back in gear. He takes it himself for a gain of 6. On second, Milton Jones goes to work. He finds room outside for 25. Safety Jake Vaughn makes the tackle. Keeping Toronto off balance. Allen, a screen pass to Chris Johnstone. He battles his way for a gain of 19. Johnstone has put Edmonton into scoring position. Allen to House. His seventh catch earns 11 yards. On the 17, first and 10, Allen calls his own number. The talented runner uses the bootleg to freeze the Argonaut linebackers. They're unable to recover in time. Allen heads straight for the corner and dives in for the TD. Edmonton is back on top 35-30 with 6:39 remaining. The Argonauts need a major to gain the lead. The Edmonton drive covers 80 yards in just 6 plays. Gil Fennerty picks up 13 yards on 2 carries. From the 46, Barrett to Darryl Smith gains 9. Now in Edmonton's territory, Darryl Smith gets a step on Edmonton's Ron Howard, but the perfectly thrown pass goes incomplete. Undaunted, Barrett finds number 88, Jeff Smith, open on the sidelines. Smith avoids a tackle, gains 25 to Edmonton's 28. Paul Pearson picks up a tough 3. From the Edmonton 25, second and seven. Barrett takes the snap.
A key play in this game. Barrett has it himself and has a touchdown. Nobody can see him score.
The call in from the bench was a perfect read of Edmonton's defense. Argos supporters are jubilant. With less than 3 minutes remaining and up by one, Toronto was unsuccessful on the two-point convert attempt. The Argonauts lead 36-35 with only 2:47 left in regulation time. For the 75th time, the silverware donated by Lord Earl Grey will be presented to the victors. Commissioner Doug Mitchell awaits the outcome along with the over 59,000 anxious fans in BC Place. Hank Elisek booms the kickoff down to Tom Richards at the Edmonton 5. Richards returns it 16 yards. Edmonton needs a single to tie and a field goal to take the lead. Starting from their own 21, Allen completes a 21-yard pass to Stephan Jones. The completion moves the markers to the Edmonton 41. Milton Jones on the screen pass. He rambles 8 yards before being tripped up by Doug Landry. Still not within range. Second and 10. Number 34 is called again. Jones gains another 14 yards to the Argonaut 45. On the day, Jones contributed 128 yards to Edmonton's cause. The Argo defense stiffens. Edmonton is faced with third and 7 from the Toronto 42. With only 45 seconds on the clock, Jerry Cowrick, in his first year of professional football, faces the biggest test of his blossoming career.
Rookie kicker, Jerry Cowrick. Good.
Jerry Cowrick, the cabinet maker's son from Windsor, Ontario, becomes part of Canadian football history. The Eskimos are back in front by 2, Edmonton 38, Toronto 36. The Argonauts have 45 seconds in which to respond. Bill Stevenson hopes for his record-tying 7th Grey Cup ring. Lance Chomick hopes for a chance to win it. Obilovich reassures and relays instructions. Barrett, who performed admirably, can't penetrate Edmonton's defensive curtain. The third down pass to Paul Pearson goes incomplete. Edmonton captures their first Grey Cup victory since 1982. It's the Eskimos' 10th in team history and 6th in 10 short years. The 75th Grey Cup has been a classic. The lead changed hands 5 times in the fourth quarter alone. Damon Allen presents the game ball to his very proud mother. The moment every Canadian professional football player dreams of.
Congratulations to the Edmonton Eskimos, Grey Cup champion.
The Edmonton Eskimos, winners of the 75th Grey Cup Championship. The final score, Edmonton 38, Toronto 36. James Bell has been an inspiration to his Edmonton Eskimo teammates all season. Damon Allen wins the Canada Lease Grey Cup Offensive MVP. Allen threw for 2 TDs and ran for another. The Canada Lease Grey Cup Defensive MVP went to Edmonton's Stuart Hill. Hill's 3 sacks were the only ones Edmonton recorded. Milson Jones was selected Canadian MVP. Jones traveled 76 yards on 9 carries. Number 34 also caught 4 passes for another 52 yards.
Come on.